Hello and welcome to the Map Framework tutorial video for Map File. In this video, you will learn what features are included in the file framework, what gets imported, and the required modifications to fully integrate the framework into your application. The Map File framework comes with the ability to enable a FIFO for one of your file devices. This FIFO will delete the oldest files once the file device starts filling up. You can configure the FIFO to delete old files based on a maximum used memory size of the file device or a maximum number of files that can exist on the file device. Note that the FIFO can only be activated on one single file device in the application. Also note that only the files in the root directory will be checked. Subfolder contents will not be included in the calculations. The optional MapView frontend includes File Explorer functionality to be able to create, delete, sort, rename, search, and copy files. As time goes on, additional features may be added to the map file framework. Be sure to check the help file of the latest version to see the full list of current features. The steps to import a map framework component are described in the overview video at the top of this playlist. If you haven't already watched that video, please do so now. After import, a file package will now appear within the infrastructure package of the logical view. The corresponding file manager task contains a number of files, which we will now go through one by one. FileManager.st is the main task code which sets up the map function blocks and calls all actions. Next, we have the local type and variable definition files. The HMI actions file handles the file explorer operations for the HMI. Lastly, the FIFO operations file handles the implementation of the FIFO for the selected file device. Also included in the file package is the localizable text file where the file alarm texts are defined. File framework will also add a USB package to the infrastructure package, which contains USB handling code. If you imported the MapView frontend, then relevant content files are included in the framework package within the pages package. You will need to assign the file content to an area on a page within your visualization. The localizable text required for the HMI is included within the map framework texts package. If you did not import the MapView frontend, then you will need to connect the HMI file variable structure elements to your visualization. Moving on to the configuration view, a file package gets added to the map services package. Here you see the map file manager UI configuration file. Next, a modular OPC UA default view file will be added to the connectivity package. The TMX files used by the file framework will be merged into the TMX files for target list in the text configuration. Some users and roles are added to the corresponding files within the user role system. All default user passwords are 123, capital A, capital B, lowercase c, and should be changed after importing the framework. If you imported the MapView frontend, a file package will be added to the MapView package, which includes all binding and event binding files necessary for the map file framework. The items required for the file framework will be merged into the .viz file you selected during import. Lastly, in the CPU configuration, a few things are changed as well. If your user partition size is less than 256 mebibytes, the value is increased as such. If you imported MapView and OPC UA is not yet enabled, this will be enabled for you. The map file content can be viewed immediately after project installation via the framework demo page in MapView. Here you see a file explorer where you can perform standard file operations on the files within the selected file device. Note that the ability to delete or cut a file from the MapView HMI is restricted to the administrator's role. To demonstrate this here, I have also imported the MapUserX framework. The default administrative user is admin with default password 123 capital A capital B lowercase c. You can use the forward and back buttons to navigate within the folder structure of the file device. The configure FIFO button is used to set up the FIFO. Choose the file device that you want to activate the FIFO on. Then choose whether you want to delete files by max quantity or by a maximum size of used memory on the file device. set the scan interval, and then enable the FIFO. The multi-select button allows you to select multiple files at once in order to perform a combined action on all selected files. And with that, we conclude our overview of the mapp file framework. Please feel free to check out the additional mapp framework tutorial videos within this playlist.